Hi, everyone. I'm Eric Demain, and this is a talk about puzzle fonts, which you may have heard me talk about at past gatherings for gardeners, this time with the theme of puzzle fonts about puzzles, because recursion. And this is joint work with Martin Demain, my dad, who many of you know, because we like to make fonts together. And I'm going to talk about five fonts today in 6 minutes. A bunch of these fonts were featured recently in the New York Times in an article by Siobhan Roberts, who spoke on Friday about Conway. So you can check that out if you're interested in more. We start with Tetris font. So here, each letter of the alphabet is made out of the 7 tetromino pieces in the game of Tetris. And here we see Tetris font spelling itself. Here's the full alphabet. And these letters were designed so that you could actually construct them in Tetris physics, so with no extreme overhangs. And we like to pair our fonts together with mathematical results. So here we published this font together with an MP completeness result, a new one showing that Tetris is hard even with just 8 columns or 4 rows. And then, so that's the font about a puzzle. Now it's a puzzle font about a puzzle. Here is a falling puzzle. So if you just take each of these pieces and drop them straight down, the question is, what words do you get? I assume it's obvious. You guys are good puzzle solvers. Let's see. We get Gathering for Gardener. And a different kind of puzzle font you get is a packing puzzle. These are quite a bit harder for those who like fun packing puzzles. Here, each of these letters can be made out of exactly the 7 tetrominoes. It's quite challenging to find them. Some of them we found by hand, but when we were designing this font, we used BurTools a lot, which is a great tool for exhaustively searching for these kinds of packing. So we could, you know, tweak a couple pixels and see, is it still makeable in a Tetris way? So that's Tetris font. Next is Sudoku font. I'm sure you all know Sudoku, most popular puzzle out there. So here we designed a puzzle that if you connect together with these purple lines consecutive numbers, like 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, and then you look for the longest path among that purple graph, you get a letter of the alphabet. So this was quite challenging to construct all the letters. It's very hard to work with consecutive numbers in Sudoku. It doesn't like to go very long. Of course, Sudoku puzzles are also MP complete. This was 20 years ago known. And so we wrote a program, we designed these long paths and then wrote a program to fill in the other clues and then remove clues until you couldn't remove any clues and still have a uniquely solvable puzzle. So we ended up with 81 different puzzles that solve to each letter. Could probably do more, but 81 seemed like a nice number, 9 by 9. And if you play with these online, you can you actually get an interactive puzzle solver like you would on the New York Times or something. And in this case, I've got hint mode turned on, so I can click on one of the green squares and figure out that's missing a 4, I think. Or if I make a mistake, it will highlight what I'm conflicting with. So these puzzles all happen to be easy to solve. You can just solve them 1 square at a time. It would be fun to work on harder versions. But on to, this solves to MG for Martin Gardner. On to the next puzzle font. This is a newer one, Yin Yang puzzles. So here the goal is to connect together all of the black pixels and connect together all of the white pixels, but you're not allowed to make a 2x2 monochromatic square. So that one definitely has to be black if that's white, and so on. This solves to Yin Yang. If you look at it from far away, it happens to be unique. And all of these letters, of course, are designed to be uniquely solvable. And this is also paired with an NP completeness result. And then we wrote a program to remove clues until the puzzle was just barely uniquely solvable, and we hand chose sort of the hardest versions of each puzzle. You can also take multiple letters. These are 2 letters joined together and made into a single puzzle for this conference. You can try it online. I'll show the links at the end. Next puzzle is path puzzles. So here you want to find a single path from the entrance to the exit, such that in each row and column you have exactly the specified number of occupied pixels. It's a puzzle by Rod Kimball of Flying Karamazov Brothers fame, and often attends Gathering for Gardner. In this case, we get PathPuzz. And here's a full alphabet paired with an MP completeness result, which we did together with Rod. Last puzzle is Tatamibari. Here you have a bunch of clues. This is a Nicolee-style puzzle. You want to decompose into little regions where the plus clues are in square regions and the vertical bar clues are in rectangles that are taller than they are wide, and vice versa with the horizontal clues. And in this case, we get the puzzle is NP hard. And indeed, we have an NP completeness result for this one as well, and a full alphabet, which we checked by exhaustive search with a computer. And that was our little tour of puzzle fonts through puzzle fonts about puzzles. If you want to see more, you can go to our fonts page or just go to my webpage and find the fonts. They're all interactive apps you can play with online and all open source. You can modify them too, and these slides themselves are also online if you check out my GitHub page. And that's it. Thanks.